We're live at landmarks across America where people are gathering tonight to watch CNN's election coverage. We're in the president's hometown of Chicago. CNN has provided the largest screen in the city for free public viewing of election coverage. We're also in Boston, Mitt Romney's home base at historic Faneuil Hall Marketplace.
Look at the Empire State Building in New York. Now take a close look at the very top, the mast. It will be following CNN's official electoral count. If President Obama wins, the top of the Empire State Building will light up in bright blue. If Governor Romney wins, the building's mast will shine bright red. We're closing in on the first results in the battle for the White House.
It is going to be an exciting night, and how close it will be.
And CNN projects President Obama will carry Vermont. CNN projects Mitt Romney will carry Kentucky. Right now, on the race to 270, Mitt Romney has 8 electoral votes based on our projection, 3 Vermont for the president.
I want to show you a little place in Indiana. Vigo County, 1.7% of the population. Only twice since 1888 has Vigo County been wrong in picking a president. Why? Good question. But since the 1950s, this county has been right. It's filling in blue at the moment. Ooh, look at that.
Both presidential campaigns know it's crunch time.
Here is the line. Here is the clock. The polls close here in about 5 minutes. A fresh wave of voters just came in.
Right now, 8 p.m. on the East Coast, Connecticut, 7 electoral votes. The president, Delaware, the president will take 3 electoral votes. The District of Columbia, Washington, D.C., and it's 3 electoral votes. His home state of Illinois, a big prize, 20 electoral votes. The president also will take Maryland, and it's 10 electoral votes. In Massachusetts, the home state of Mitt Romney, all 11 electoral votes. In Maine, 3 of the 4 electoral votes. Rhode Island, all 4 electoral votes we project will go for the president. Oklahoma in Romney's corner, and it's 7 electoral votes. Right now, the president has 64 electoral votes in his corner. We project Mitt Romney has 40 in his corner. Let's check over at the Empire State Building in New York. Remember, we're turning the mast red and blue to reflect the electoral votes. Watch the colored columns rise. There's another watch party going on. You're looking at live pictures from Chicago. We're following also the battle for control of the United States Senate in a brand new way in CNN's virtual Senate.
Whomever wins the presidency, his ability to get the job done and do what he wants is going to depend on what happens in the U.S. Senate tonight.
In the state of Massachusetts, CNN is projecting that the Democratic candidate Elizabeth Warren has unseated the Republican incumbent Scott Brown. Missouri Democrat Claire McCaskill, she is also going to go on to win re-election, she beating Todd Akin, who very famously talked about rape and abortion in a way that had the entire Republican Party on him to try to get out of the race.
CNN projects the Republicans will maintain their majority in the House of Representatives. CNN projects the Democrats will retain their majority in the United States Senate. In Kansas, we project Kansas will be won by Mitt Romney. Nebraska, we project he will get 3 of the 5 electoral votes. In North Dakota, another 3 electoral votes. Look at this, Texas, 38 electoral votes, all going for Mitt Romney. In Michigan, the home of the U.S. auto industry, will be in the president's column, 16 electoral votes. The president picks up all 29 electoral votes in New York State, and he does in New Jersey as well, 14 electoral votes. Our latest electoral vote projections, here it goes. Right now, on the race to 270, Mitt Romney has 152. The president of the United States has 123. CNN projects Pennsylvania will be won by the president of the United States. They're watching CNN over at Obama headquarters in Chicago right now.
To them, this is a sign that their campaign is on track to do what they plan to do.
From what I see so far, and it's not conclusive, I would rather be Obama than Romney.
We project the president of the United States will win the state of New Hampshire, with New Hampshire in the president's column. Look at how close it is. All right, CNN can project that California will be won by the president of the United States. Hawaii, where he was born. 4 electoral votes. Moving quickly right now, Wisconsin, we project, will be won by the president of the United States. They're thrilled over there at President Obama's campaign headquarters in Chicago. They're dancing over there at campaign headquarters. CNN projects that Barack Obama will be reelected president of the United States. He will remain in the White House for another 4 years because we project he will carry the state of Ohio. By carrying Ohio, he wins re-election. The president of the United States defeats Mitt Romney. In this, at this time, right now, we have made this projection. So the president wins this battle for the White House. They're excited in Chicago. They're excited at Times Square in New York. They're watching all over the world right now. The President of the United States has been reelected.
I have just called President Obama to congratulate him on his victory. His supporters and his campaign also deserve congratulations. I wish all of them well, but particularly the President, the First Lady, and their daughters.
And whether I earned your vote or not, I have listened to you. I have learned from you. And you've made me a better president. I return to the White House more determined and more inspired than ever about the work there is to do and the future that lies ahead.